Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I will introduce you to libraries to do parallel processing, parallel transformations in pandas data frames. I will introduce you two libraries. DAX is a well-known library, not only used to work with pandas, it's also used to work with graph libraries. Not only as well in Python, also in language like R, and also with the machine learning libraries to use to do machine learning training, and with all others to do hyperparameter tuning. So it's a very flexible library. It's a general purpose library for parallel and distributed computing. The second library I will introduce you is PandaRLL. This library is only working with pandas data frame. It's replacing the method apply and applied in few words in parallel, no? Maply is doing the same as PandaRLL, but we will not look at this as it's exactly the same as PandaRLL. It's another version which they claim to be more optimized, but at the end of the day you can take a look to the documentation and install it and do your own test. It's gonna be the same that PandaRLL. That's, as I said, is a general purpose library. There is a multiple, let's check 1 second, install DAX is coming with multiple sub libraries, and it can work as you can see here with multiple graph libraries, machine learning, matplotlib also for graphs. Also can work as well with processes, or can parallelize the execution of different processes. So it's very complete library, complex, very complex as well, and well, it's worth it to have it, worth it to know how it works, and at the same time it's quite complex. It's working under the hood with creating a graph which optimizing the transformations that you apply to an array, data frame, bug, whatever you are doing. And then first of all, create the graph. Is you know Spark or Databricks is essentially the same concept. Is first of all, create a DAG, a graph of processes and transformations, and once this graph is optimized, is applied to the data frame itself. First of all, create this according to the number of partitions or cores that you had available, and then on this graph is optimized and applied to the data frames at the end. Is what we know like lazy executions. Only if you just apply the transformation to the data frame without compute, like in the case of the Spark, you need to do a transformation and one of the operations which execute the DAG, the graph itself. If you don't do it, nothing happens. It's just creating the graph itself, but nothing happens to the data frame. In this case, it's exactly the same. You need to create the graph, the task graph, which had the name of DAX, and then on after you don't execute or compute with the command compute or the method compute, nothing is applied to the data frame. And again, this can be applied to not only to data frames, to also different or work with different other libraries, like especially graph libraries, which also demand a lot of computation, a lot of CPU, sometimes even GPU. Yeah, and you can also parallelize how the graphs are created on the CPU. Take a look to the documentation, which is worthy, at least worthy to know how it works and how you can apply to different scenarios. Pandarallel, as I said, is much more simple. This is simply divide or split the data frame in different chunks and apply the transformation of each chunk in one available core of your CPU. So you have the same data types, you can apply a maximum in parallel if it will be able to run N processes or N transformations. So DAX is not exactly doing that, it's apply tax small components to the partitions, so you can have multiple partitions, so the DAX is progressing, not applying all the transformation at the same chunk. That is how it's working. That Pandarallel is much more simple. It's not creating a DAG, a task graph for the execution. There is no optimization of the task. It's simply applying the transformation to individual chunks of the data frame. Maply is doing the same. You have here the documentation of all of them. You can take a look later on and understand the big difference. But you will see in any case, and as I repeat in all the videos I'm uploading about this topic, like the same we did with Namba, with FunTools or Vectorize, NumPy Vectorize, all these tested. Test how this apply to your specific scenario, because well, in some scenarios they are not working, they are performing even worse than the conventional methods, as we saw before with Numba or with FunTools. Not always these methods are suitable for every transformation that you want to apply. Some scenarios are not working, are performing even worse than the conventional methods that are coming, for example, with Pandas, you will see now on the video. So we import the libraries. Later I will upload this to the repo as usual to you in order you to see. Let's restart the kernel just to start this process from scratch. So we import the libraries. We create a data frame of 5 million of rows. Here where we got a warning. No, it's not a warning, it's an info just telling us that Pandarallel is going to use 8 workers. I have 16 cores in my machine, but Pandarallel will use only 8. So you will see now, I will use only 16 threads in this case, but later I will show you that how apply the number. So here the concept of my rationale with that was, well, you can, it, how it works this, you probably will say, well, if I make a lot of partitions, it will be better because, yeah, divide and win, no? This is the concept, and somehow it's true, but here you need to consider all the extra processing that you need to do, first of all, to create the DAG, the task graph, and secondly, to execute, which is something that is what you want to do. You will do the execution in this case. We see 16 partitions in these 16 chunks of our data frame. And finally, these transformations or these chunks need to be collected and grouped again or aggregated again in a single data frame. Have to be on the same order and return it to the user. This extra work will be only worthy is the function is so heavy, so computational demanding that, and also the data frame is so huge that this extra work that is done at the beginning is worthy to be applied. To do, we are going to try something. The previous video that I did, I use 5 millions. We are going to use 50 millions and see it is really happening what I think. So we are going to apply this function, and then on we are going to create 16. We will see how long it takes to apply. Yeah, it's going to take a lot of time in any case. Well, yeah. So let's see how long it takes to apply to 50 millions of rows, and then we will do it with DAX. I will stop this here because it's going to take a while. Oops. Yes. Pandas apply. Oh, yeah, exactly. This is not defined here. So I will stop it here. Once it's done, we will review the outcomes, as it's gonna take a little bit this. Okay, the process has finished. Pandas applied took 678 seconds, and DAX took 551 seconds. In total, it's an improvement. I will say 551 divided 678 roundabout. And now I'm processing the with PandaRel. As you can see here, it took 8 workers. Essentially, divide the data frame in 8 chunks and apply the transformation. It's going to be quicker, but it's still probably, yeah, less than the here it was practically 9, 10 minutes, and this practically is 11 minutes, something like that. Let's wait a little bit, and once it's finished, PandaRel, we will continue. Okay, it's finishing now. Let's wait a little bit more. Now, once it finished, it needs to collect all the intermediary outputs, all the intermediary chunks, and collect them and merge them again and return, well, the final output. Yeah, it's you need to consider here we have the 50 million rows. It's taking a while. So, well, let's wait a little bit more. Okay, this is done. It took 358, and let's so with DAX 16 partitions, we improved around about 20%, and practically it's gonna be 50% with yeah, 0, yeah, 50% of the time. So again, it's better, obviously. There is no doubt that this is performing better with the DAX and with the PandaRel. But consider, for example, what we did with Namba some days ago when I just use the just-in-time compiler of Namba, and then something similar. It was only 1 million rows, and using apply took 18.2 seconds, and using the just-in-time compiler without parallelization took 3.27, and using parallelization 1.37 milliseconds. which in the worst case scenario for the data frame means a improvement of 5,565. Anyway, these are operations which are very simple, but it's just an example. But yeah, we need to consider what is doing. This is only applying in the case of the number, only apply for a function with just a very simple function. We can compile it and be very optimized because it's in machine code, it's in binary code, what is being compiled, and it's working very fast because it's close to the language that the CPU understand. And in this case, what we are doing is processing in parallel using the all the CPUs that we have available in our computer, and somehow optimizing the transformation in the case of DAC, but it's different. Where this will be worth it to be applied? I guess that when the transformation is extremely complex, and also the number of rows is millions and millions of rows, this is first of all, it will be not suitable probably to apply a number compilation. I showed you as well yesterday or the day before. When you have a complex transformation, the just-in-time compiler is not working very well because it needs to transform the all this transformation in Python to something equivalent in binary code, in the machine code, and that the time it needs to do the compilation is eating the time that is improving. So probably in the case that we had a very extremely complex transformation, that it will be the only place that where DAX or Pandarallel makes sense to be used. As I said before, you need to try it. You need to check all the tools. I show you all these libraries and see which one is performing better. I have here the same example with NumPy vectorize, and you can see here 1.31 seconds is something similar to 1.0. Yeah, let's divide this. In the same example I tried before with 5 million rods, and then I just like you see here 657 times faster. So yeah, it's and then we can check Pandarallel 678 divide to Pandarallel is 1.88 times faster. And here we do the same, and DAX is 123 times faster. So, well, again, is going fast here. The transformation is not very complex, and then probably here there is no such real advantage in doing the processing in parallel using all the CPUs that you had. And well, I left to try with some of your personal use cases and understand. My objective here is show you how it works and introduce you the technologies and give you some examples on how it can be used. We are going to use the same with that we use here with the number just-in-time compiler. And if you watch this video, you may see that we got better performance just simply using the apply in Pandas data frame. It was apply the method apply used with a Pandas series, and then applying the just-in-time compiler also was worse than that used directly the apply. And here you are gonna see that is exactly the same. We use the same method, the best version, the version which is already optimized. I know that the version is terrible, terrible. This we never should use an if block here to do this comparison. It's extremely inefficient to do it like this, but it's just an example. And then here I adapt it a little bit just to use it with DAX. And then we convert here as well the pandas data frame into a DAX data frame. You can see here the partitions. Every partition here, we have 16 partitions, the partition 0. You can treat it exactly the same like a pandas data frame, but it's a different object. When you check the type of object, it's a DAX data frame. It's not a pandas data frame, which collection data frame, so it's not a pandas. You check the type of the original one. It's a different objects, so essentially it's a wrapper to be working, yeah. And yeah, but you can apply practically the same methods that you apply to a pandas data frame. So here we prepare the transformation. We are going to apply to the data frame this transformation, which is already prepared. It's exactly the same that here, but we're just accessing, because as you remember, we need to send rows with the method apply, and then it's quite inefficient to the apply with lambda row, because you need to pass the whole row. Here is not a big issue because the row is just the same column that you need, but let's imagine that you had 500,000 columns, and then this will affect strictly to the performance. And then, well, we test it with the apply here. So here, I don't know, I test it, time it, and then on apply as well here with DAX. So in DAX, many times you will need to specify the data type of the attribute. There is multiple attributes as you are working on, you have to enumerate them in a dictionary like this with the parameter meta. Here we have just one column, it had to be str, but if you had others, you have to build a dictionary. You can take a look to the documentation how to do that. And the scheduler just means that we are going to use threads. You can use processes as well. And then we will use threads according to the same that the number of partitions that we are having there. So apply to 141 milliseconds, and time it is going to take a while, so I will stop it after it's done. So it took 11.4 seconds, and I hope you see how it was here. It was run it. It took some seconds to prepare it, and then immediately finish it. 4.06 seconds in with pandas parallel. So as you can see, both methods are performing badly in comparison with the simply apply. As you probably know, is probably one of the best methods to apply directly in pandas. It's better than iter rows, obviously, but well, in this case, why? I think I explained at the beginning of the video, if you need to build here the DAX graph, or sea, the DAX graph, and also you need to split the data frame, you need to create a graph. These optimizations of the all the transformations that need to be done, and later on you have to collect. We can do this here again, just to you understand how long it takes. You see, it's taking a while, and then immediately, yeah, this time that where you see that all the bars are initialized is that the data frame is being splitted, and then on applying the transformations is very very fast, no? Maybe if we increase this to 10 million of rows, it's gonna be better. But well, I don't think that the DAX is gonna be the simply apply in this scenario. The transformations have to be probably applying to multiple columns, case that to be effective in DAX or in parallel, in pandaraler, need to be more complex transformations and applying to multiple columns to be efficient. We can do a try. Let's do it with 10 millions and see what happened. So it's gonna take here, okay. We split it. Yeah, it's gonna take some time. Let's check. Every chunk have 600. Yeah, correct. We create a function. Let's do time it. And then on this one. I will stop it. When it's finished, I will be back.